Now, let's suppose we go to the next stage. First electrical activity, second, third, fourth, and here is the fifth. Now, let's take these electrical graphs, electrical vectors, right, of this heart and apply a galvanometer there. You remember the galvanometer from last lecture? Let's see it. Here is this man. He's very happy. You know why he's happy? Because he understands the ECG to some extent now. So he's very, very happy. Okay. Right? I've shown a very big heart there, but actually heart is of course smaller. But what I'm showing, that this is the heart of this person. These are the electrical events in his heart during one cardiac cycle. I've not shown the ventricular repolarization, that I will discuss later, right? Now, what we do, we apply our galvanometer to this person and see what are the needle fluctuation due to these vectors. It will be fun. Now, let's suppose that here is our galvanometer and we break down its window and take its needle out. This is that galvanometer. Here it has, we apply, let's suppose, positive electrode on the foot, left foot. Suppose we apply the positive electrode here and we apply the negative electrode. What is this? Right arm. So the same galvanometer we have applied to this person and we want to see what type of needle fluctuations are produced by the electrical activity of the heart. Because when during one cardiac cycle, electrical vectors are produced due to electrical events. And these electrical vectors and electrical potentials are very faithfully conducted to the body surface through the body fluids. The very small electrical activity of the heart produces very miniature voltages up to skin. Body is a very good volume conductor. Right, even very small electrical currents which are produced during the one cardiac cycle or each cardiac cycle, they are very faithfully conducted up to the body surface. It is such a volume, good conductor. If you don't trust that body is a good conductor, you can do a small experiment. Put your finger into any electrical plug. Suddenly you will know that body is a very good conductor. Take care, don't do it anywhere. Right? Now listen. So electrical activity of heart comes to the body surface. So we can apply the electrode on the body surface and pick up the electrical activity which is going on deep into heart. Is that right? Now listen. We have applied the positive electrode on the foot because it is convenient to apply here. But actually, whatever electrical current is coming to this point, this will be conducted to the foot. So it means applying the electrode to the foot is equivalent to applying the electrode at the junction of the left lower limb and the trunk. In the same way, when you apply the electrode on the right arm, actually position of electrode, that position of the electrode will sense the same electrical activity which electrode could sense when electrode is applied at the junction of right upper limb and the trunk, right? Again, let me repeat it. For key convenience, I have applied the negative electrode here and positive electrode on the foot. Is that right? Basically, whatever electrical activity is here is the same which is conducted in the arm. So either you put electrode here or here, it will be doing the receiving the same result. In the same way, you apply the electrode here or you apply the electrode on the foot. Right? What really happens, that electrical activity which is reaching here right? That will be recorded. Is that right? Now, so for practical purposes, we can say that positive electrode which is on the foot is actually here, right? This is the positive electrode. And negative electrode which is on the right, what? Right arm, right? This is practically here, right? Now, these are the positions of the electrodes. And we have to see that how these vectors will move this needle. Let's do a little scientific work. What we do, we take a paper roll. Roll of paper. And this is a roll of paper. Is that right? This is paper roll. We put it vertically, and here, let's suppose this is a wooden stand, and we have applied this paper roll on the stand. Is that right? We are making ECG machine by one moving paper roll and a galvanometer. That's the simplest form of ECG machine. Here is a small motor, and this motor is constantly moving the paper in this direction, right? So paper is moving in this way. Is that right? Paper is moving in this direction. Now what we do? We are ready with our ECG machine. This was galvanometer, very sensitive one. Put positive electrode here, here. Negative electrode on the right side of the trunk, right upper side. Clear? More truly speaking, on the right arm. Now, we brought this needle out. We brought this needle out. And let's suppose on this needle tip, we put some black ink. We put a black ink. Is that right? And we make the switch on, and this paper start moving under the needle. When this paper is moving under the needle, if there is no electrical activity in the heart, listen now carefully, rather you have to answer. If there is no electrical activity in the heart, right, no vectors are there, do you think this needle will fluctuate or it will remain at a steady point, neutral position? So when there is no electrical activity in the heart, these electrodes don't sense anything, needle remain at the neutral position. Because paper is moving under the needle, so it will make a straight line. Is that right? Then, suddenly, SNode fires. Suddenly, SNode fire. And first electrical event start. That is the spreading of depolarization on atria. And which electrical vector is produced? Atrial vector is produced. What is produced? Atrial vector is produced. When this atrial vector is produced, this atrial depolarizing vector is moving towards the positive electrode or away? It is moving towards the positive electrode. So deflection should be positive. You know that when positive charges move to the positive electrode, deflection will be positive. So needle will move upward. Remember that this side is, this is zero position. Here it is positive side and this is negative side. Deflections which are upward, they are positive deflection. Deflections which are downward, they are negative deflection. So when atria is undergoing depolarization, a small vector is moving towards the positive electrode. So there will be small positive deflection. And it is moderate velocity. So this will be, needle will go upward positively with moderate speed, not fast speed. So as paper is moving under it, so during atrial depolarization, when needle is gradually lifted upward, as this vector is moving towards the positive electrode, this wave will be generated on the paper. This wave represent what thing? Atrial depolarization. This wave is generated by the needle in response to atrial depolarizing vector, right? And this is a slow wave, not a fast wave. Is that right? And a small deflection because atrial vector is small one. What is the next electrical event? Now ATR completely depolarized. When ATR completely depolarized, needle will come back to neutral position. Clear? Now the next electrical event is, what is this? AV nodal depolarization. When AV node is undergoing depolarization, do you think there is any significant current which will move the needle? No. So we say this electrically, heart is silent. We say this AV nodal silence. So when current is conducting through AV node, these electrodes don't pick up any activity, so needle will remain straight. So after the end of the atrial depolarization and before the beginning of ventricular depolarization, current is held in AV node, but that current activity is so small that needle is not, electrode don't sense anything, needle will not move, so there will be a straight line. So this straight line represents that needle is not fluctuating. Why the needle is not fluctuating? Because right now current is passing through AV node, and AV node is a small tissue. Electrical activity is so small, the needle does not fluctuate. Is that right? So this small piece, right, this represent conduction through AV node. Is that right? What is the next electrical event? Suddenly current is released into Purkinje system. As soon as current is released into Purkinje system, ventricular depolarization start. Depolarization wave spreads through the ventricle. The first electrical event is septal depolarization. Now, when ventricular septal is undergoing depolarization, a small vector is produced. So there will be small deflection. But this vector is moving towards the positive electrode, or this vector is moving away? Because this vector is moving away from the positive electrode, so deflection will be negative, but small deflection. And because it is fast vector, so there is small deflection, which is negative, but slow or fast? Fast. So needle will move, when ventricular depolarization is there, needle will move fastly, a little deflection down, and then come back. So when it will rapidly move, it will make a wave like this. So this wave, this needle fluctuation represent ventricular septal depolarization. Is that right? The first wave is called P wave. So P wave represent atrial depolarization. After that, this straight line represent conduction through AV node. Then this is showing the onset of ventricular depolarization, and the small but fast negative wave, here it is representing what? Ventricular septal depolarization, right? Now, what is the next electrical event? Next electrical event is current is going now to the major part of the both ventricles. And both ventricles, when major ventricular depolarization is started going on, now the next electrical event is, after the septal depolarization, there is major ventricular depolarization. During major ventricular depolarization, a very strong vector is produced downward and leftward, strong and fast. The strong and fast vector, which is representing the electrical activity in major ventricular depolarization, this vector is moving towards the positive electrode or away? It is moving towards the positive electrode. So deflection will be negative or positive? It will be positive, because positive charge is moving towards the positive electrode. So deflection will be positive, number one. Number two, deflection will be slow or fast? Fast. And deflection will be small or big? So what happens? Strong, big deflection in a fast fashion. So when needle, when major ventricular depolarization is going on, a very strong and fast vector approaching the positive electrode, needle suddenly move strongly, positively, but fastly. So needle suddenly move upward and comes down. So this wave is, this is called R wave, and this wave is due to major ventricular depolarization. This R wave is produced by the sudden upward deflection of needle, and this deflection is fast. It reaches rapidly to the peak and come down. And what is it is representing? It is representing the major ventricular depolarization, which is strong depolarization but fast depolarization, and depolarization is moving downward and leftward toward the positive electrode. So because depolarization is moving towards the positive electrode, deflection is positive. Because it is strong vector, so deflection is high amplitude. And because fast vector, so deflection is sudden up and down. Am I clear? After that, what is the next electrical event? Next electrical event is the last electrical event in spread of ventricular depolarization. So last electrical event is, now current goes to the basal part of the ventricle. When depolarizing current reaches basal part of the ventricle, it produces small vectors which are moving upward and rightward. Now listen carefully. These basal ventricular depolarization produces small vectors which are moving upward and rightward. So these vectors are moving towards the positive electrode or away? Away. So when these vectors are generated, they are moving away from the positive electrode, they will produce a negative deflection. And because these are small vectors, so they will produce small negative deflection. And fast vector, so there will be small negative but fast deflection. So needle will move a little down and then back. So that will produce small negative deflection. Is that right? And this is S wave. So S wave is representative of basal ventricular depolarization. Now let's look at whole this complex. The three waves, Q, R, S. Three waves together are called Q, R, S complex. Again, listen. Q wave represent here in this study which we are doing. Q wave is representing ventricular septal depolarization. R wave shows that depolarization spreading over major ventricular part, and S wave is showing that depolarization spread into basal ventricular part. Am I clear?